The expression arm's length transaction means a transaction between two related parties, which is conducted as if they were unrelated, so that there is no conflict of interest. Okay, so which means that I deal with my brother, but I give him the exact same terms that I would give to anybody else who were unrelated to me. There is no difference. And I am able to prove that in the past I have dealt with other people on the same terms and the same manner of determination of the transaction as I am doing with my brother. So it's an arm's length transaction. Even though we are both related, the transaction is conducted in such a manner as if they were unrelated. If I give you a very clear example, and I have lived out of India for a while. In India, many times what happens is that, you know, sons will take any money or any funds that are given by their fathers as their own. It doesn't make, like, father gives the funds, they are supposed to give the funds to us for doing any kind of activities or anything. But if you go out, then they will say that, okay, dad gave me a loan. Okay, they will make a statement like this. So even though they are related, that thing becomes a loan. So the son is supposed to repay it. And it's carried out in the same manner as it would if he were borrowed from someone else. If he were borrowing it from someone else. Okay. So that's an arm's length transaction, as that you are carrying out the transaction in the exact same manner that you would have done if that party was entirely unrelated to you. So the question is how to determine if it's an arm's length transaction. So you should have to have evidence for this effect. Is that, you know, this is the fair market value or this is the fair price that is prevailing for these transactions. So you sort of make a determination that, you know, these are the price for the goods that is prevailing in the market, which you have obtained by research through different means. And that's the same price that I'm offering to this party, even though they are related. So you must be able to make a kind of a market price or a market level level terms which are there prevailing for other parties for that specific transaction. Okay, that is one thing. The other important thing which you need to note is it needs to be in the ordinary course of business of the company. Okay, so let us say if a company is buying wholesale goods from someone and selling it in retail, then if it falls within that category of the transactions, it will be considered or sort of in the ordinary course of business. But if it's going ahead and purchasing a plant, like how we just discussed, like for the M&A transaction, if it is doing that kind of transaction, then it is not something which is in the ordinary course of business of the company. So even if it is on arm's length, if it is not in the ordinary course of business of the company, then again it will fall within the catch of the section and you would have to comply everything that deals with that. So there are two conditions which has to be fulfilled. Ordinary course of business of the company. The company is usually buying and selling these materials, usually engaging in this kind of transactions. Okay, and normally and on a daily basis dealing in these kind of transactions, then you can clearly establish that it's the ordinary course of business of the company. And arm's length means it has entered into a variety of transactions with different people and all of them have been offered the same terms as the related party. That becomes a very clear evidence that it's an arm's length transaction. Okay, so you have to put in place evidence or keep evidence on record to know that it's an arm's length transaction.